I hope you're having a lovely day so far. Today, we're gonna have some fun with drinks. Summer is here and I wanted to show you how to make and enjoy a cold, sweet sangria that packs a punch. Not just any sangria, three types of sangria. White wine, red wine and cava sangria. If you don't have cava, then you can substitute it with champagne or sparkling wine. Let's get mixing. Cut the fruits into tiny pieces. Now we have our lovely spread ready. Here we have all our fruits cut up and we can start making our sangrias one by one. For the red wine sangria, we need strawberries, lemons, raspberries, blueberries and oranges. There's no exact measurements as to how many you want to use. I mean, if you like strawberries more, use more of that. If you like oranges more, use more of that. If you don't have the berries, that's okay. You can use whatever you like, but kind of the most important ones are oranges, lemons. Let's get started. In your serving dish, you can start by adding oranges, then strawberries, then some lemons, raspberries, and finally some blueberries. Next, add 1 to 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, depending on how sweet you want it to be. You can put 1 to 2 shots each of Cointreau, rum, and brandy. Next, add some ice, followed by lemon soda or tonic water. Finally, add a whole bottle of red wine. At the end, decorate with more oranges and lemons, and it's ready to be served.
Wow, that looks great!
Now we're going to make the white wine sangria. For that, we're using bananas, kiwis, lemons, oranges, pears, apples, grapes, blueberries, white grapes. Again, there are no fixed measurements. You can use how much ever you want of each fruit.
Squish the fruit as you put them in, which will add more flavor to the sangria. We can start with white and black grapes, followed by pears, kiwis, bananas, apples, oranges, lemons, and finally blueberries. We're adding white sugar to this because we don't want any flavor of molasses that comes with brown sugar. Add 1 to 2 shots each of brandy, rum, and Cointreau. We're smashing the fruit again, so all the flavors infuse into the sangria. Next, add your lemon soda or tonic water, followed by a whole bottle of white wine. I use semi-dry white wine, but you can use any white wine you like. Add some ice, stir well, and it's ready.
The procedure for the cava sangria is exactly the same as the white wine sangria.
If you want to make a non-alcoholic version of this sangria, you can make it with the same fruit, tonic water, and red or white grape juice.
So that's it for today, guys. It's time for me to go serve these sangrias to my friends and have a fiesta. If you make these sangrias, don't forget to tag me at Infinity Platter on Instagram. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on lovely recipes like this and all my future adventures. Until next time, cheers!